Hello again and welcome to yet another Views from the Veranda. Well look, there's a lot of properties selling at auction at the moment and very high clearance rates, and I know a lot of buyers are missing out on property at auctions. I know clients of my own who've actually been chasing the market at the moment, so I've been giving them a few tips and my views on how to win at auction. So firstly, don't jump in with a very much an opening bid. Sometimes it's better to hold back and come in with a strong bid towards the end. That way you know who your competitors are. Sometimes the property is on the market, that is, it's hit the reserve, and you're able to actually wait till all the bargain buyers are out of the bidding process as well. Make sure that your first bid is a strong bid. In this day and age, it's a very transparent market, and it's very easy to understand what a property might be worth. There are all the banking apps, there's realestate.com and Domain, and even talking with the agent themselves. So most buyers have an idea that a bidding of what the property is worth, and they're going to go in with that same sort of idea in terms of price. So that's why when you do make a bid, make sure it's a good strong bid. The third point is bid in round numbers. Don't bid in small odd numbers like, you know, $1,500,000 and $500, because what a competitor will do is just go up another $500. So if another bidder starts to slow the bidding down in smaller increments, you need to go back quickly and confidently. So that's my third point. What you need to do is identify the fact that you are a serious bidder, not only with other bidders, but also with the agent, and go in strong and confidently. The third point to make on all this is that set a budget, and that's where we've seen a lot of buyers walk into these auctions without a predetermined maximum price in mind. Oftentimes a buyer and yourselves, you have an idea of what you'd love to get the property for, what you think you'll get the property for, and what you actually will pay to buy the property. So in that point, when you do actually make start bidding, you're working with a predetermined budget. Even though you might be falling in love with the property, you need to understand that and work within that. Although, having said that, you don't want to miss out on a property at a price you were prepared to pay. So an extra $1,000, $1,500 can sometimes make the difference. Which leads me into my last point, which is talk to the agent. A lot of bidders hold back and they try to fly under the radar during an auction. I think it's important to actually identify yourself with the agent and with the auctioneer that you are a serious bidder. They're here to help you through the process and give you advice of what's happening during the course of the auction. I've had instances myself where a buyer's come up to me after an auction and said, "Oh look, that was a price that I could afford to pay." And they start blaming the agent. Well, the problem is they didn't actually talk with the agent during the whole campaign. Which leads me into my last point, in that obviously that's what we're here, to give you advice on how to sell at auction, to get the best price for your property, how to buy at auction so you get that property that you love. So contact us and message us. So look, you all have a great Mother's Day and look after your mothers this Sunday. But until next time, take care and look after each other. Thank you.